Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to use the new AirPlay Receiver function on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a new feature in macOS Monterey is the ability to use your Mac as an AirPlay Receiver. So you can AirPlay an iPhone, an iPad, or even another Mac to your Mac, just like you can do it from one of those devices to an Apple TV. Now to enable this, you need to go into System Preferences and then look for Sharing. And then look for AirPlay Receiver. Go to that and turn it on. So then you need to decide whether AirPlay is only available for the current user. So in other words, you can AirPlay from your iPhone to your Mac as long as you're using the same Apple ID. Or you can choose allow anyone on the same network. So this is similar to how Apple TV would work. Anybody using the same Wi-Fi network would be able to AirPlay. You still have to confirm using a code, so it's not like you can take somebody else's Mac over while you're at work. You would need to see the code on their screen. Or you can allow everyone, so anybody nearby. It doesn't even have to be on the same Wi-Fi network. You also can require a password. Now you have to enter in the matching code if you don't use this, but if you use this, then you could set a password and there is no matching code to see on the screen. Somebody needs to know the password in order to connect using AirPlay. So once you have that turned on, you start things on the other device. Again, it works just like it does to an Apple TV. So let's say we're just going to mirror the screen. I'm going to bring up Control Center here and then tap Screen Mirroring. And then you'll see all of your AirPlay devices. I have a few Apple TVs available and I have this Mac Pro here. I'll select that. And you see on my Mac screen, I have to accept. And now the screen is mirroring. So now everything I do on my iPhone, I'll see it here on my Mac screen. It basically turns the Mac screen into an Apple TV, just showing whatever's on the iPhone. Only functionality here on the Mac is this little control here. If you move the pointer, you'll see the ability to stop AirPlay. And in this case, since I have two screens, I could say switch to the other display. And you could also just stop screen mirroring on your iPhone like you could normally. So I'll turn it off here. Now I had previously AirPlayed from my iPhone to my Mac before, so I didn't have to enter in the code a second time. But the first time you do it, you're going to have to enter in that code. So if I try it here with my iPad, I'm going to use Control Center, Screen Mirror to the Mac Pro. And you could see I have to accept, and then it's going to show a code on my Mac screen. I have to enter in that code on my iPad and OK before the screen mirroring will start. But the next time I do it, I won't have to enter that code. It knows that AirPlay is allowed between those two devices. Now this also works with other AirPlay modes. For instance, if I go to the Photos app, I could be looking at a picture here and I could go and share that picture and choose the method of sharing as AirPlay. And then I get to choose the Mac Pro like before. And now you can see it will show there on the Mac's screen. And I could even use my iPhone screen and swipe over and it will show the next photo. And then I could stop AirPlay right here to turn it off or do it on the Mac side. Now you can also AirPlay to your Mac's speakers. So here I am in the Music app and I could tap here and you can see I could AirPlay to various devices including my HomePod, Bluetooth devices, things like that. And I can now choose my Mac Pro and you can see I can AirPlay just the audio. And notice if I look in Control Center down on my Mac, it will show what's playing from my iPhone and I can even control it to some extent. And just like with any other Bluetooth AirPlay device, I can tap here and go back to iPhone for the output and that will turn off the AirPlay streaming. That also works in any other app that can do AirPlay on a second screen like that. Like for instance Keynote to do a presentation. Now there are two other options I want you to know about. One is if you choose allow AirPlay for everyone, it will work even if you're not connected to the same Wi-Fi network. So it's working wirelessly directly from one device to the other. And also it'll work if you connect a device by USB. So if you connect your phone using the USB cable to your Mac, then you can do AirPlay that way, which will allow for a faster, lower latency connection. Now this isn't going to work on older Macs. You need to have a certain level of hardware for this. So check out this page at the Apple site, which gives you the details of what's new in macOS Monterey. If you scroll down to AirPlay to Mac, you'll see there's footnote 7. Go to that footnote and you'll see the list of requirements. So what's this good for? Well, it's good for a variety of situations. The audio function is great if you have some great speakers hooked up to your Mac and you just want to play your music from your iPhone to your Mac, or you want to allow somebody else to play their music through the speakers on your Mac. If you have your Mac hooked up to a projector or large screen at a meeting, you can enable this to allow somebody else in the meeting to show something from their Mac, iPhone, or iPad. If you're presenting from your Mac and you want to switch to showing something on the iPhone, like demonstrating an app, you can AirPlay from your iPhone to the Mac, which is then hooked up to the large screen or projector. So there are a variety of use cases. Let me know what you would use it for in the comments below. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.